All right, here we go. Let me just. So here we're gonna kind of do a regular haircut, not too short on the side, maybe down to 3, and then leave the top. We'll take about inch and a half of the top, and you wanna kind of keep the curl and messy top, right?
Mm-hmm.
We are not doing a part on each side. We are blending both sides, right? Check that out. All right. All right. There you go. So first thing, we're gonna just do a little trick here on the mask so we can get it out of our way. So what I wanna do with his hair is, I'm just gonna comb it out like this. I'm not gonna actually section it. Just keep your head straight for me. And then I'm gonna start probably with 4, and I'm gonna freehand it kind of out, out, out. And I'm gonna keep in mind the square shape that I want to create, okay? All right, let's see this.
Pause. May I pause?
Mm-hmm. All right, so look down for me, sir. I'm gonna start with the number 4. I'm gonna kind of freehand this one. So even though I'm using 4, I'm actually not cutting down to 4. I start with 4, but I freehand as I go up. Just like that, you see? Now the other way I could have done, I could have sectioned the hair at the horseshoe shape, cut the sides in the back first, and then cut the top, but since his hair kind of is like standing out, I'm just gonna try to freehand this. So now I'm going to actually use a clipper over comb to remove the bulk here. I want to keep in mind also shape. Shape is very important in the haircut. So I'm going to try to keep in mind the square shape here. Always try to use wide combs for clipper over combs like this, so you don't cut on either side here.
Stop it.
All right. Look down, sir. Perfect. When was the last haircut?
Like 3 months ago, during my college.
Perfect. Are you from Berlin?
Hmm?
Are you from this area here?
Yeah, I'm from Wadersfield. Oh.
Okay. So here we're just gonna go closer. Anytime I do a cuff like this, I like to taper this and this neckline and the sideburns area, because this grows very fast.
So
shape him up now. I like to keep a natural hairline here. A lot of times barbers go like this. But it first it looks better to have a wide neckline here, right? And second, when it grows out, like if you cut this here, in a few days this starts growing. So it doesn't really look good. So besides this looking better, it's more practical.
So I cut the sides first and now I'm just gonna connect.
So now we have a nice square line here. And we're just gonna slightly round the corners. I don't like them to be like too square or too round.
Perfect.
Because his hair was so long and all over, I'm gonna wash it, that way the hair comes down and then we can cut the top, okay? Ah, see? Right. All right, so about 5 minutes of relaxing shampoo and scalp massage with Aveda products. All right, my friend. Man, this looks good. So, but tell me, how much should we take off the top?
Maybe like that.
Yeah, that's good.
All right. Well, let's cut it with a razor because it will give you definitely better texture. So, let's lean back a little bit. 1 second. Okay, lean back. Okay.
All right, so we're gonna cut it with a razor. So he's got very nice thick hair, so we create some texture in his hair, and I believe it will also enhance the curls. I pull the hair straight at 90 degrees, you see? And so that's why I have my client reclining. All right.
Corn.
All right. So now we're going to connect the back with scissor or the comb to the top. Yeah, when you talk like stuff like that, you gotta be off camera. Just remember. So we have a nice square shape, nice messy to curly top, clean sides, and here we go. Alright guys, this is MC. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, take care of yourself.